Hi friend, welcome back to Raman's Tutorials for GK. This is Rangaraju from Tumkur. Dear friend, today we are going to discuss about new topic, that is chemical reaction and chemical equations. Dear friend, this topic is very important for competitive examination. Now let us discuss in detail one by one. Chemical reaction. Dear friend, chemical reaction involves the making and breaking of bonds between atoms to produce new substances. That is, chemical changes or chemical reactions are the reactions in which one or more new substances are formed. So this is called chemical reaction. Now let us move to the chemical equation. Chemical equation, it is a representation of a chemical reaction in terms of symbols and formulae of the reactants and product is known as chemical equations. That is, chemical equation is a chemical reaction. That means the symbolic representation in the form of a symbols and formulae. For example, C plus O2 gives rise to CO2. So this is the one of the chemical equation in which C is carbon, O is oxygen. After the reaction, after the chemical reaction takes place, the new substances is obtained, that is carbon dioxide, CO2. So this is the symbolic representation in the form of symbol or formulae is called as chemical equation. So this is the example for chemical equation. And then one more example is magnesium reacts with oxygen. Magnesium reacts with oxygen, Mg plus O2. Magnesium reacts with oxygen, gives rise to magnesium oxide, MgO. Magnesium oxide. That means when magnesium reacts with oxygen, gives rise to magnesium oxide. Now let us move to the one more concept, important concept, that is balanced chemical equation. Dear friend, balanced chemical equation is an equation for a chemical reaction in which the number of atoms for each element in the reaction and the total charge are the same for both the reactants and product, also known as conservation of energy and mass. Dear friend, why balanced equations, chemical equations takes place under the chemistry? Because it is the most important phenomenon, that is conservation of energy and mass. That is the chemical equation in which the number of atoms of different element is same on both sides of the arrow mark is called balanced chemical equations. Now, what is the purpose of chemical equation? The purpose of chemical equations be balanced is the mass of substances produced in a chemical reaction is always equal to the mass of reacting substances. Therefore, you need to have the same number of elements on each side of chemical reaction, that is on product side and reactant side. Now let us take one example. Here Mg plus O2. Mg plus O2 gives rise to MgO. MgO. Now let us balance this equation. Here in the reactant side, magnesium is one element, oxygen is two, whereas in the product side, magnesium is 1, oxygen is 2. Therefore, we have to balance on either side. Then we have to add 2 in the product side, that is 2MgO. That means magnesium element becomes 2, whereas in reactant side only 1. Therefore, you have to put here 1 magnesium into 2, that is 2 magnesium oxide. Now, balance on either side, that is 2 magnesium here also 2 magnesium. Oxygen is here 2 into O, that is 2 oxygen. So, this is the way of balancing the equation. Now, the skeletal chemical equations means unbalanced. Sometimes chemical equations is unbalanced. Now let us discuss an example for unbalanced equations. Now consider the same example, that is Mg plus O gives rise to MgO. Is it balanced? No, because it is not balanced equations. So, it is unbalanced equations. On either side, the element does not match each other. For example, magnesium in reactant side is it matched, but oxygen in the reactant side is not matched with the product side. Therefore, it is unbalanced chemical equations. Dear friend, let us move to the types of chemical reactions. The chemical reactions can be classified into different types, such as combination reaction, then first one is combination reaction, second decomposition reaction, then third displacement reaction, and then fourth double displacement reaction, and oxidation, reduction, etc. Now let us discuss in details. That is, first one is combination reaction. Dear friend, combination reaction means, the name itself indicates, two or more reactant combined to form a new substances are called combination reaction. Once again, two or more reactant combined to form a single product. Two or more reactant combined to form a single product is called as combination reaction. For example, when magnesium plus oxygen gives rise to magnesium oxide. So, here in the reactant side, two substances combined. Magnesium is a substance, that is solid substances. Oxygen is gaseous substances. Therefore, magnesium plus oxygen, two substances combined to form a magnesium oxide. Now, let us take one more example, that is carbon plus O2. Carbon is solid in state and oxygen is gas in state. Therefore, gives rise to carbon dioxide. In this example also, two substances are going to combine to each other to get one substance, that is carbon dioxide, and it is produced. So, this is called as combination reaction. Once again, dear friend, combination reaction means two or more reactant combined to form a single product. The general equation is A plus B plus C, that implies ABC, it is a single product. So, this is a general formula for combination reaction. There are so many examples. One more example is quicklime CaO reacts with the liquid water CaO reacts with CaO reacts with water H2O. CaO calcium oxide is called as quicklime, gives rise to calcium hydroxide, slaked lime CaOH twice plus heat. Therefore, in this example also, two reactant substances, one is calcium oxide and another one is water, react to each other to give rise to single product, that is calcium hydroxide. It is in the aqueous solution. It is also called as slaked lime, and also heat is produced. So this is about combination reaction. Decomposition reaction, the reaction in which a single compound breaks up into two or more simpler substances are called decomposition reaction. Dear friend, a single compound break down to give two or more simpler substances. Here the general equation is AB is the compound. When this AB compound, when heat is supplied to the AB compound, then it implies A plus B plus C, etc. So this reaction is called as decomposition reaction. Once again, a single compound break down to give two or more simpler substances. This reaction is called as decomposition reaction. For example, the decomposition of a substance by passing electric current through it is known as electrolysis. One more example here, ferrous sulfate, that is in solid substances, ferrous sulfate FeSO4 is treated with heat. Heat gives rise to Fe2O3 plus SO2 plus SO3. Here, dear friend, ferrous sulfate is one of the compound. When heat is supplied to this ferrous sulfate, single compound break down, this ferrous sulfate compound break down into 2 to 3 simpler substances. For example, ferric oxide Fe2O3, sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, etc. So this is one of the examples for decomposition reaction. Now let us consider one more example, that is calcium carbonate. When calcium carbonate CaCO3 calcium carbonate reacts with or undergoing decomposition reaction, it is supplied, then it implies calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. Here calcium oxide is called quicklime and CaCO3 is called limestone. Dear friend, when limestone undergoes decomposition reaction, it gives rise to quicklime and carbon dioxide. So this is the one of the example for decomposition reactions. Now let us move to one more example, important example. When lead nitrate is undergoing heating process, what happens when lead nitrates, that is PbNO3 twice undergoing heating gives rise to lead oxide PbO plus NO2 plus oxygen, NO2 plus oxygen O2. Balance the equation here, 2 PbO, here also 2 and here 4. Here one of the most important here, brown fumes is produced by the element, that is nitrogen dioxide. So this is one of the example for decomposition reaction. One more example is silver chloride, AgCl. Actually AgCl is in white color. When silver chloride undergoing decomposition reaction, it decompose into 2 to 3 simpler substances, that is silver Ag plus chlorine Cl2. Now balance the equation, here 2 Ag plus Cl2. Here silver is gray in color, that means when you expose silver chloride into the sunlight, what happens, the color white color of AgCl is converted into gray color, that means it decomposes into 2 to 3 simpler substances. This reaction is called as decomposition reaction. Next example, that is silver bromide. Dear friend, silver bromide, this compound is especially used for photographic techniques. That is, in silver bromide, AgBr solid, in silver bromide is sunlight gives rise to silver Ag, it is solid, plus bromine gas Br2, bromine gas. Now balance the equation, 2Ag here also 2Ag. That means when silver bromide exposed to sunlight, it decomposes into two simpler substances, that is silver and bromine. These reactions are used in black and white photography techniques. Yes, one more example is the decomposition of a substance on heating is known as thermal decomposition. Once again, thermal decomposition means the decomposition of a substance on heating. For example, calcium carbonate, it is also undergoing heating, that is called thermal decomposition. Ferrous sulfate, it splits into 2 to 3 fragments, ferric oxide, sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, it is also a thermal decomposition. Lead, nitrates, PbNO3 twice, it is also a thermal decomposition. In lead nitrates, the obtained products is lead oxide and nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide is responsible for the forming a brown fumes. Then silver chloride, it is a photosolution decomposition. Dear friend, silver chloride exposed to the sunlight, silver chloride, color of the silver chloride is white in color. When it is exposed to the sunlight, it decomposes into 2 to 3 fragments, that is silver and chlorine. The obtained product silver is gray in color. So this is about photosolution, the decomposition of a substances absorbing light, that means sunlight, is called photosolution decomposition. Once again, photosolution decomposition is decomposition of a substance by absorbing light energy is called photosolution decomposition. The example is silver bromide. When silver bromide exposed to the sunlight, this technique is used in the black and white photography technique. That is, when silver bromide exposed to the sunlight, then silver and bromine is produced. This is about decomposition reaction. Decomposition reaction means a single compound break down to give two to more simpler substances is called decomposition reaction. Dear friend, in this video, we already discussed about the meaning of chemical reaction, chemical equation, and two types of chemical reaction. First one is combination reaction and also some examples, and decomposition reaction and also some examples. Dear friend, in the next video, we will discuss about the other types of chemical reactions, that is displacement reaction, double displacement reaction, and reduction, oxidation, etc. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.